Okay, I got my new helmet. AGV K3 2.0 Birdie. Now, I think the Birdie looks really cool. He's a little beady eyes looking down the road. But I also like this little grin, which is pretty cool. And then they have these little pulleys down here that you pull down to take the face shield off on both sides. Up here they got the vents. These things feel a little cheap, but you know, for the price of the helmet. But the biggest thing that I was doing, so I was researching a lot of helmets, looking for the good helmets, FIM, ECE 2206. And that's one of my favorite things about this helmet. So I went riding yesterday, and there it is. That's what I'm looking for. I've got the DOT sticker on. Obviously, you got to have the government sticker on it. And this authenticates that it's an AGV, that it's real. But I really like the colors. Very nice helmet. Very light, actually. And so what I did is I went back through and took a measure, a tailor's measure, measured my head. So this guy's 60 centimeters, which is the large, which is perfect. It fits nice and tight. I can't get two fingers in there. It's got this little push-up vent right here. And I'll show you. So if I'm riding down and let's say I want to get some air, I just do that and it allows air to seep in through there. But then I can also come up and it ratchets really easy. And then down here, right down here, see a little tab right there, brings down the pilot visor, and it's smooth. It brings it down real smooth. So I got the pilot visor, and then here opens the front vents. So if I want air in, and I got a pin lock. Pin lock came with the helmet. I haven't installed it yet because it's not cold enough yet. So when it gets colder, I'll install it. But my main thing is protection. So wearing my helmet, my gear, my gloves, my moto boots, moto pants, I mean, that saved me my wreck of the 28th of September. The thing that I researched, and I got a video about it, you know, with the Snell, FIM, ECE 2206, DOT, government sticker, hasn't changed since 74, very, very few changes. I had my Rurock 4.0 Atlas with the Rayon technology, and I still got a TBI. So here's the thing. I mean, I get it. I know a lot of people that like to ride without helmets, wear sandals, wear jeans, wear sweatpants, t-shirts, and that's, hey, by all means, do what you're going to do. But I learned a tremendous amount from this wreck. I actually got into investigating the different testing that are done on these helmets. ECE 2205 didn't do penetration tests. So that's a big thing for me, because I definitely don't want something going through the shell and stabbing me in the brain. ECE 2206 does, and they shoot a high-powered BB to the face shield to see if it breaks, and that's important. So my face shield on my Rurock didn't even break. It didn't even come off the helmet. You know, sometimes you'll see that people's fly off on if you watch YouTube wrecks and that kind of stuff. Anyway, it didn't do that. I get these laboratories, you know, they're bouncing helmets off of things, you know, scientifically, and saying, well, this is how people are going to do it, this is what's going to happen. But I can tell you from experience, man, from my wreck, that had I been wearing a three-quarter or half-face helmet, I hit here, smashed here, 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 and across here, and in these areas. And I'm telling you, had I been wearing a three-quarter or what people call it sometimes, a brain bucket, my nose and my freaking lips may have been gone. My jaw definitely would have been destroyed. And maybe I would have been protected up here at this point. But here's my thing. that actually happened. I got to see the after effects of what my helmet went through. And ECE 22.06 protection that it has, and the DOT sticker, obviously. And I know that the helmet held up, and it held up great. So I'm looking for ECE 22.06 or FIM. I know some people like Snellen. By all means, there's two different types there, so you really have to research that so you can see. I think they contradict themselves. One may be double here, so double impact, but I mean, how many times are you gonna bounce your head off the same rock? You know, maybe if you go down a hill, that's possible. But again, this helmet for me fits my budget, and that's the thing. It fits my budget, but it also, I know it has a classification to save my life. And the inside of the padding is nice and thick too. I don't know, I'm sure some of you have probably already seen these helmets. AGV helmets, I'm sure some people, but it's nice and thick in here. You know, padding is padding, but if you come up here, you got very light padding, and just, I mean, it's just interesting because it's not thick here, but that interior is pretty thick. Anyway, that's what I've learned from doing what I've done. Getting in a wreck like that, it teaches me that wearing my gear is very important, and not to be thinking, hey, I look cool, because I think gear looks cool anyway, depending on what you're wearing, obviously. Some stuff may look like you're a construction worker, but or playing hockey, maybe, I don't know. But either way, if it protects you, it protects you. And that's the coolest thing, is that you're gonna get to live to ride again if anything should happen. So keeping that in mind, 37% more likely to survive in a crash with a helmet on from any kind of brain damage or broken jaws or anything like that. But yeah, I think that's the biggest thing, is looking at the percentages, kind of like playing the lottery, you know, or playing gambling, if you like gambling. If you got a 37% more of a chance to win at the blackjack table versus the roulette table, where are you gonna go? It kind of makes sense to go where I have a 37% more of a chance of survival. And with the gear I was wearing, no road rash, no broken bones, that saved me. So does it mean that you can't die? No, it doesn't mean that, but your chances are better. So something that keeps me safer is the fact that I do neck exercises, and I exercise pretty regularly, eat regularly, well, keep my body as strong as I can. So I mean, even the doctor said that I had a remarkable thorax, which, you know, again, the way you eat, the way you exercise, the things that you do for your body also help you in a lot of things in life, stretching, that kind of stuff. But again, what are you going to do when it comes to keeping yourself safe? Well, for me, if I have a greater percentage of chance of winning in life and being able to ride for the rest of my life, I'm going to do that. Anybody else, if you want to ride with no helmet, no gloves, shorts, flip-flops, go for it. That's your prerogative, and I'm cool with that. I just know when I see people like that, they haven't wrecked. And when you do wreck, trust me, it hurts and it sucks. And the longer it takes for you to heal, the longer it is before you get on your bike. But you know, they told me that my season was over, and I'm like, no, my season's not over. I'm good. It's been about, well, close to a month now since the 28th. But hey, I went out riding yesterday, tried my helmet out. It was great. I still have my techniques, practice, and that's the biggest thing. Courses, practice, and practice, and practice. Does that also mean that you're not going to wreck? No. Sometimes these things happen quickly, and you have to make a choice. And the choice you make isn't going to take 2 minutes, 3 minutes. It's literally seconds, less than nanoseconds. I mean, it's quick. And once you decide and you're set on your escape route, then you go take it. And that's what I did, and I didn't wreck into any cars. I didn't wreck into four ways. I didn't hit anybody else. I wrecked on my own. I was going off into the dirt, and there's a hill hump, and I hit that hump, and I went over the bike. So basically, I did the high end, which is it's the most dangerous in motorcycles. And anyway, I'm here to still tell the story because I wore the gear that I wore, and I'll always wear it. But again, to each his own. If you've been riding for 20, 30, 40, 50 years without wrecking, cool. That's awesome. I wasn't so fortunate. So anyway, that's the biggest thing. Coursework, practice. Again, do they heighten the odds of survival? Absolutely. That's why I do them. I do them because I want to become a better rider. I want to learn more. But at the same time, it also keeps me safer and alive longer and where I can ride motorcycles longer. So that being said, pick your poison and do it wisely. You know, I don't know what you guys look for in a helmet, but if you want, let me know. It'd be kind of cool. You know, I can look at the different things, and if you have different ideas of how Snell may work, how FIM may work, how ECE 2205 or 2206 works, or how DOTs, I mean, you tell me what kind of helmet you look for, besides obviously what it has on it. I just kind of found this one to be really cool, and there's other ones obviously, but it fits my budget and it's going to definitely keep me safe with the ECE rating of 22.06. So that being said, it's a pretty cool helmet. Lightweight, not too heavy, and it guarantees 37% that if I do get in another accident, my head's going to stay intact. Again, there are no 100% in life anyway, so let's be vigilant, practice, and always stay safe out there. So